towards the end of the 90s, Ducati was ruling the roost. They had the 916, which obviously later on went to the 996. Foggitt was ruling World Superbikes, but it wasn't long before the Japanese wanted a piece of the action. Honda brought out the Firestorm, Suzuki brought out the TL1000S, and Aprilia, just started 2000, end of the 90s, brought out the Mealy. And these bikes were all £8,000-£9,000 when new, but now time's moved on, and you get these bikes for less than £2,500, which was a real, real surprise. So we thought, well, time, money's tight, and the credit crunch is on, why not get these bikes back out, £2,500 V-twin test, and see what they're like in the modern day. So this was Honda's answer to the 916. Honda's Firestorm before the SP1 and the SP2. V-twin, similar radiators to the SP1 and SP2, with them both on the side, and a really, really good bike, very underestimated. This is a lovely little R-plate, it's £1,500 from a dealership, and you get a bit of warranty with that, and 12 months MOT and 12 months tax. It's showing its age fairly well, there's nothing really to account for, there's no horror stories with a Honda. Standard exhaust, always try and keep an eye out for a standard bike. Good tyres, keep a check for those. The original bikes used to come on Macadam 90s, which were a bit of a nightmare and not the best for grip. But all in all, for £1,500, you've got a lovely V-twin, 100 brake horsepower, a sports tourer by modern standards, but still a really good bike. Aprilia give us the RSV Mealy. Believe it or not, this is a £2,500 bike. X-Wedge, and it's aged extremely, extremely well. Goddard was one of the development riders, and obviously Corsa and Hager were famous for taking wins in World Superbikes. Today, I think the bike still looks really, really good, and it's £2,500. What to look out for? Well, the bike's a bit physically bigger than any other of the V-twins. So if you're on a short guy like yourself, take it for a test ride. Other things you need to look out for is the usual Italian finish, as it been through a couple of British winters. Check the Benbro brakes, check all the finishings, check all the fixtures, the shock linkage, and also a lot of these bikes ended up raced in track day. So check for obvious use of race usage. Check that the sump plug's not being drilled, check that there's no wire locking, and make sure the fairing's in the same condition as the rest of the bike, as the fairing being kept in a garage while it's been raced for a few years. If you shop wisely, £2,500, I mean, we're all taken back by this. That's a bargain bike and it still looks good today. And this is Suzuki's attempt into the V-twin market, the legendary TL1000S. Now this attracted a different type of clientele. This was a real headbangers bike. And by to modern standards, the engine is still a peach. But you've got to be careful with these. They don't age as well as the Honda or the Aprilia even. And this has had a bit of a hard life, but there's telltale signs that it's been loved in a certain way. You've got wavy discs, the aftermarket cans, bits of carbon fibre. But what you've got to really make sure it's got the steering damper. They have real headbanging problems. It was all to do with the linkage system on the rear shock. Bit scary to ride, not the best handling, but an awesome engine. And if you want the headbanger's choice, then this is the one. And this is under £2,000. That's an over 110 brake horsepower V-twin for less than £2,000 that'll wheelie everywhere. We've been out on the bikes all day long, we've been battling the weather, it's not been great, but still we're having a bit of fun, and we're proving that these real cheap bikes are good fun. So what have we learnt so far? Well, it's really, really important to take these bikes for a test ride. We've found little faults with the TL that weren't really apparent when you look at the bike, but the clutch is heavy, the brakes aren't strong, it's really backfiring on the fueling as well, but the engine's really strong and it's a good fun bike. The Firestorm, it's a perfect little bike, really good, but it's just lacking a little. It's not got the engine to match either the TL or the Aprilia, and the suspension's pretty soft, but it's a lovely, easy bike to ride, very, very comfy, and a good bike. And the Aprilia, we're still surprised it's only £2,500. It's a really, really lovely bike.
does everything that the old Aprilia did. It feels like a new bike, nothing that's done 12,000 miles. But where would your money lie? Rob, where would your money lie?
RSV.
RSV, and easy. Why?
Just for $2,500, it's an absolutely beautiful example of it. Too much wrong with the TL. The Firestorm, you wouldn't go wrong for how much it's up for. I mean, £1,500 isn't a lot of money when you're thinking of a bike. 1,000cc bike, V-twin, does all you want it to do. Definitely a good learner's big bike, first big bike.
And Justin?
Definitely Aprilia. No question on that. It's completely sorted. It's a full-on race bike. Absolutely. Like you say, the TL, a few things wrong with that. Firestorm is a nice bike, but it doesn't do it for me. Twin's all about the engine. I think the TL edges it.
So just to summarise what we've got, the TL's definitely got the engine. It's a cracking bike, but it's showing its age. The Firestorm, easy to ride, beautiful bike, ideal for like your first big bike almost, and it's cheap. But we'd all still go with the Aprilia. It's £2,500, but it's a great £2,500. Great on track, great on road, and it still looks the part.